Always remember, when you are giving induction to a pregnant lady, first find out the indications, either she is candidate for it or not. Rule out the contraindications. That is very important. Try to predict success of induction of labor with the help of ultrasound and Bishop scoring. And choose the best method of induction of labor for that pregnant lady. Now, first there are indications of induction of labor. What are the indications of induction of labor? We can divide it into maternal causes and the fetal causes that are the indications of induction of labor. Number one, or the most commonly, it is the prolonged pregnancy after 41 completed weeks, and it is most important MCQ. Pre-labor rupture of membranes. If there is pre-labor rupture of membranes, labor should be started within 24 hours. If it does not start, give induction of labor within 24 hours. Do not delay. Otherwise, there will be high risk of ascending infection like chorioamnionitis. So according to NICE guidelines, induction of labor reduces the rates of chorioamnionitis, endometriitis, and admission to the neonatal unit. Now, if a pregnant lady has gestational diabetes, or she has intrahepatic cholestasis of pregnancy, or the twin pregnancy, plan her induction at 38 weeks gestation, right? So this is again an important MCQ question. When there is gestational diabetes, when there is intrahepatic cholestasis of pregnancy, when there is a twin pregnancy, do not delay after 38 weeks. Now the preeclampsia and unexplained antepartum hemorrhage is also the indication of induction of labor. But if the maternal health is deteriorating, just go for C-section. But if mother and the fetus is stable and there is no stress to them, then plan induction of labor. Maternal isoimmunization against red cell antigens is also the indication of induction of labor. Social issues in our society are also the indications of induction of labor. Fetal causes. Fetal growth restriction, fetal macrosomia, in the absence of maternal diabetes, right? And fetal demise, mean intrauterine death, are also indications of induction of labor. I have made a fun learning mnemonics. Kindly watch them to memorize all the indications in the form of a story, and you will enjoy them. The link is present in the description box. Now, you have to rule out all the contraindications. What are the contraindications of induction of labor? Contraindications can be divided into absolute contraindication and relative contraindication, and you should know both because examiner asks for both. Now, absolute contraindications are those that also applies for normal vaginal delivery. Mean if a pregnant lady is not the candidate for normal vaginal delivery, so we cannot give induction of labor to that pregnant lady. So if someone asks you what are the contraindications of normal vaginal delivery, just remember them. And if someone asks you what are the contraindications of induction of labor, just memorize them, right? So it is the vasa previa, placenta previa, previous classical hysterectomy or C-section, myomectomy that involves in the uterine cavity or endometrium, active genital herpes, umbilical cord prolapse, abnormal lie, mean transverse lie, or the oblique lie. Now the relative contraindications include cervical carcinoma, breech presentation, and lower segment C-section. Mostly this question comes in exam, that what is the relative contraindication of induction of labor, and breech presentation is given in options, right? So this is very important. In cervical carcinoma, breech presentation, and lower segment C-section, we can give induction of labor if benefits outweigh the risks. But consult the patient about the risks. For example, if a pregnant lady has history of previous one scar or a previous one lower segment C-section, and if she wants vaginal delivery, there is a risk of uterine rupture, and the risk is 1 in 200. But if induction is given in such pregnant lady, the risk of uterine rupture increases from 1 in 200 to 1 in 70. That is an important point. So consult the patients about the risks. Memorize all the indications of induction of labor and memorize all the contraindications of induction of labor. This is very important VIVA, OSCE and MCQ question. Number third point, predict the success of induction of labor and how you can predict. You can predict the success of induction of labor by ultrasound and modified Bishop sporing. On ultrasound, you have to find the length of cervix. If length of cervix is long, it predicts the failure of labor induction. But if on ultrasound, the length of cervix is short, it predicts the success of labor induction. So ultrasound can help you. In our clinical practice, the most commonly used assessment of cervical ripening is the modified Bishop scoring. Mean we do the vaginal examination and we check the five components of the cervix. Higher the Bishop scoring, mean higher the rates of success of induction of labor, and lower the Bishop scoring mean less chances of success of induction of labor. So what is modified Bishop score? First, there was Bishop scoring, in which in place of length of cervix there was mentioned the effacement of cervix, but in modified Bishop score we use the length of cervix in place of effacement of cervix. Just this is the difference. In modified Bishop score we quantify the state of readiness of the cervix and fetus. Either the cervix is favorable or not. Because if cervix is favorable, the induction of labor will be beneficial for her. If cervix is not favorable, the cervix will not favorable for her. So you check the dilation of cervix, you check the length of cervix, you check the position of cervix, you check the fetal station, and you check the consistency of the cervix in modified Bishop score. Modified Bishop score is very important topic. A lot of questions come from this topic. So you must have a good grip. Just clear cut, you should know that we do this scoring to check the favorability of the cervix. Either cervix is favorable for the induction of labor or not. If score is 8 or more, means cervix is favorable. If score is 6 or less, it means cervix is not favorable. Just right, if cervix is not favorable, there are higher chances of failure of induction. If cervix is favorable, there are higher chances of success of induction. And this was the concept, right? And how you do scoring is very important. Maximum scores are 13. As we know that this scoring has 5 components. We have to check dilation of cervix. If cervix is not dilated, you give 0 score. If cervix is 1 to 2 cm dilated, you give 1 score. If cervix is 3 to 4 cm dilated, you give 2 score. If cervix is 5 or more than 5 cm dilated, you give the 3 scores, right? You know that the consistency of cervix can be firm, medium or soft. If it is soft, maximum scores it can get is 2. That is important thing. You cannot give it 3 marks. Remember that consistency of cervix and the position of cervix can get maximum 2 marks. Right? This is important thing. First, the cervix have posterior position, that it comes in the middle and then it comes anterior. So if cervix is anterior in any scenario, in any MCQ, it means it has 2 points. If cervix is soft, it means it has 2 points. Dilation of cervix, length of cervix and station of presenting part can get maximum marks 3. So it can get 3 marks, it can get 3 marks, it can get 3 marks. So if we add 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 2 and plus 2, the highest scores are 13. For example, if in any scenario it is written that cervix is 4 cm dilated. When cervix is 4 cm dilated, it can get maximum 2 scores, right? Because if cervix is 3 to 4 cm dilated, we can give 2 scores. And if consistency of cervix is mentioned soft, we will give 2 scores. If the length of cervix is mentioned 0.5 cm, we will give again 2 scores. And if the position of cervix is anterior, we will give 2 scores. If the station or presenting part is 0 station, we will give 2 scores. So, the total scores are, we will add them. So, total scores are 10 out of 13. I have made detailed video on modified Bishop score. The link is present in the description box. Kindly watch that video. Because modified Bishop score is very important topic, never ever miss this topic. In next video, I will tell you the methods of induction of labor, and that is very important video.